Hey, Matthew.
It's James. Hey, there's basically four steps to this thing, but step one is to you'll need a pair of these kind of these electrician scissors that have this threading along the side. I'll show you why that's important in a minute. But you want to clip the damaged ends, like to make it even, and then use one of these guys. These are like a dollar. These things are cheap, but basically. And you don't have to use this per se, but it's about getting that tip off. Hold on, let me get a better one. That one's a little loose. You were probably using scissors or something. This one's actually loose too. Pretty weird. Anyway, but the idea is to get it exposed like you probably did. Let me get the wires exposed. So basically what I do is I get this little string separated out from the wire, so it's out of the way, and then I go orange, white, orange, green, white, blue, so there's orange, white, orange, and I start just untwisting them so that, you know, they're ready to get lined up with the orange, white, orange, green, white, blue stuff. Let me get them all untwisted, and we'll arrange them. And I usually give myself a lot of line here, because if you don't give yourself much, it's kind of hard to work with. So I give myself plenty of room here. So we're saying orange, white, orange. So I peel those off to the side. And I grab green, white, blue. And this is why you want to make them long, so you have some room to pull them off to the side. And you don't have a lot of wires going over like that, right? So orange, white, orange, green, white, blue, blue, white, green, and then brown, white, brown. But you'll notice that what I'm doing while I'm doing this lineup, I'm also kind of bending them back and forth like this. What that's doing is it's loosening up the wires and making them more straight. It doesn't get them all the way straight, but it's helpful. So orange, white, orange, green, white, blue, white, green. Then I bring brown, white, brown into them, and I kind of do some more of that, you know, wiggling back and forth to make them malleable. And then that's where these scissors come in. The threading right here, that's designed so you can comb the wires and get them straight, right? So you want to get them straight as possible, so when you insert them, it's a smooth insert. So checking to make sure they're still orange, white, orange, green, white, blue, white, green, brown, white, brown. And you see where that one's kind of crossing over. So we're going to actually cut it like right about here. I like to cut it like one thumb's distance, like the tip of your thumb, about that far in. So I would probably cut it right here before I insert it. But I'm going to keep combing them because I want to, where I cut it, I want it to be very straight so it inserts into the tip real easily. So I feel like that's probably pretty good where I'm going to cut it. Well, there's still a little, you know, space there. So I'm going to work that. It's important to get that set up first because it makes it a lot easier to insert it into the tip. See, it's starting to get really close together here. So orange, white, orange, green, white, blue. Blue, white, green, brown, white, brown. All right, that's pretty good. I mean, that's really close together. So I'm going to cut it straight across to make sure that when I insert it, it's got every wire is flush against the end of this little connector right here. So I'm going to insert it with this little flippy thing down so it'll go in like that, right? Now, I do a little trick. I have these little pliers handy. Because what happens is when you try to push them in, sometimes these wires will try to push back into the cable. And that's no good. So what I do is I get it started, like I slide it in and just get it inserted to where it's hanging on like that, right? And then I take these pliers and I grab the end of them and then I push it in the rest of the way. That way, you see it crosses over the little metal there, so it crosses over, so when you crimp it, it'll go down. And I can see the tips on the end bumping up against the plastic. That's how you know you got them in all the way. And after that, I just crimp it and you're good to go. So that right there is awesome. So that's how you do it. Okie doke. I'll shoot this video over here in just a second. Check you later.